All right, Chris, this is your video on bass 3. It's gonna be a little bit long of a video, so you should just, you know, listen to everything I have to say, practice the, you know, hand movements a few times, or just kind of get it straight in your head, because it will be complicated. You're gonna take 6 barbarians. You're gonna take 4 archers. You're gonna take 2 giants. You're gonna take 2 wall breakers. You're gonna take 2 balloons, 4 wizards, 22 hogs, and 2 golems, because you said you wanted to use 2 golems. So I try to make the army around that. All right. So let's talk about how you're gonna attack. I think you should just go ahead and just get rid of your balloons first, okay? So you're gonna launch a balloon over here on this exposed cannon and one onto this archer tower. You know, launch them as close, you know, to the 2 defenses as possible, so they don't have to travel very long, and they should just destroy those 2 structures right away. The reason you're doing this is so that your hogs will not get diverted whatsoever. You can't afford the travel time for your hogs, even though they're kind of fast. Okay, so that's step 1. Step 2 is you're going to have to do the clan castle lore. This guy's got 25 troops, and from what I've seen from, like, the other replays and stuff, I think what they got is 3 wizards and, like, all the rest archers. So that's, like, 13 archers, which is, like, a pain in the butt to just pull with barbarians and such. So... and giant. That's why you're taking your barbarians and giants. So notice that this guy has an exposed spawn spite right here. Okay, probably very purposeful. He probably has a giant bomb right inside there. So just go ahead and drop one barb. Okay. And you should see a giant bomb explosion. Okay, it should appear and then it'll explode. Okay, just let it explode, and that will also start to pull some troops out. Then go ahead and drop one giant. Okay, and it'll go after this cannon. It's gonna die. I mean, there's no way it's gonna survive. But just drop it there, and it'll pull more clan castle troops out. Let it die. All right, then drop your second giant in that spawn site. And hopefully with all of that, it should pull all of the clan castle troops out, which is 3 wizards and, you know, all the rest archers. If you still don't see 3 wizards, you're going to have to use a hog at that point in the spawn site. Or just drop another barb in the spawn site. Actually, if it doesn't work... Or if you don't see that many troops come out, okay, you're gonna lure over here to the laboratory anyways. So just go ahead and drop your archer over here. It's gonna start pulling the troops over, okay? Once whatever troops have come out, you know, have crossed this line, just start looking and seeing whether you have 3 wizards and, you know, see if you have 3 wizards. If you have 3 wizards, that means everything is pulled, because wizards come out last, so all the archers were definitely pulled. If there's only 2 wizards, then go ahead and drop another barbarian here. And because these troops are already so far away, the extra troops should come out. Okay, so you're just going to use 1 troop at a time. You know, you just kind of, you got to be fast with it, but you can't be so fast that you're dropping 2 giants in there at the same time. And such.
You need to make sure that you only drop 1 troop, and then all the troops, and then the troops that you drop die before you put another troop in there. Okay, anyway, so...
Okay, so now you've got, you know, your archer here, and it's pulling all the clan castle troops over. Okay. You know, this archer is going to die, but the group of troops is not going to be necessarily together yet. So drop an archer here. On this elixir storage, and just drop them, alternate between this position and this position, until you get them like tightly bunched, all right, and then drop, your Kilskod clan castle over here, by them, and then you can also drop your BK and your archer queen behind, okay. All right, as soon as you drop your BK and archer queen in your clan castle, and they're engaging the CC troops, just like, they'll take care of the CC troops. Just don't even worry about them for right now. Okay? Because you're going to run out of time otherwise. Okay. So now you got your kill squad over here. And like I said, there's a double giant bomb here, and there's definitely a small bomb here. So what you're going to do is you're going to put one golem over here. And you're going to put one golem over here. And you're going to wait until you see both of those bombs blow up. You have to actually see them blow up. They can appear and then they take like a second to blow up. Once this guy blows up, okay, send in your two wall breakers. And you're only taking two, so this is hit or miss right here, okay? That should blow up that compartment. And then this golem and those two golems should go inside here, okay? And now, your kill squad will be able to go inside and engage this queen and take her out and take out this stuff. And so your kill squad is going to go this way.
Okay.
So, that all needs to happen within, 45 seconds or so. 30 seconds. 45 seconds. No more than 45 seconds. So once all that, once all that's there, I think your kill squad, your BK, your archer queen, you're just going to monitor their health in now that you can monitor their health on the buttons themselves, make sure you don't trigger their abilities until they're like super low on health. Okay. So now you're going to launch the next wave of your attack. I suspect that there is also a giant bomb here, so you're going to want to put one barbarian down here to trigger this giant bomb. After you trigger that giant bomb, you can then launch into your hog attack. And you should take... I know we talked about taking a jump spell, but I think that you should... I think you might just need four heal spells for this battle, and just let your golem just travel down this way with your heroes and stuff, because your archer queen, which is kind of like behind everybody, should be able to shoot into this base anyways. So launch your hogs here, and you got a heal spell. Here, you got a heal spell here, you got a heal spell here. You're only taking 22 hogs, and you're more the hog expert than I am. You can launch just all 22 coming in this way and, kind of let them travel the base. Or, you can split. I mean, you could split hogs and do like half towards one expo and half towards the other expo. This expo here should be
engaged with the
you might want to take that down quickly so they don't like take your heroes down. This expo doesn't necessarily reach, so if you do think that you can get away with three heal spells and a jump spell, then you could put a jump spell here. You want to make sure that the jump spell is actually kind of far in, because you don't want the jump spell to like go into this part of the base. You want only the jump spell edge to be in this compartment
okay, because it's the only compartment that's like reached, you know, is reachable by both expos.
It's your choice if you're going to take a jump spell or you can take four spells. It's more important for you to just have enough heal spells to take down all the defenses than to get your golems into the core that's there.
Okay, so, you know, you've used a few barbarians, you've used all your, you know, you've used your two balloons, you've used your giants to lure, you've launched all your hogs, you've launched your golems, you have four, so you're taking four wizards, mostly because of cleanup. You know, this base just has so much crap all around it. So just kind of like, you know, just take note as your kill squad is like engaged with the base, and like what defenses are down, because like you need these wizards to survive. You know, hopefully your kill squad, you know, takes out all this stuff. You know, the Archer Queen, you know, might take this out as well. If you, you know, well, okay. You're definitely going to want to put a wizard on this DE storage over here. And if you take out... Yeah. And you're going to want to put, like, a wizard over here to take this out. This spot might look like a good spot for the for a wizard, but my worry is that you're going to put a wizard there and... You know, it starts cleaning up all this stuff, but this Barbarian King is going to come out and then kill it, which is just a waste. So I would let your hogs kind of take care of this side of the base after all the defenses go down. So I would rather you just put most of your wizards kind of on this side. You know, because you've launched hogs this way, so this should all be gone. And it's all defenses, you know, except for this elixir collector. So, you know, those wizards can come in and take care of that wizard collector, or I'm sorry, that elixir collector. And you can, you know, save once your hogs. You can save one wizard to like the very very end. You know, if you don't, you might not even need these two wizards. So you know, you have one here and you have one here. You're taking four. You know, you might need one here on this gold storage as well. And then if they, you know, if your kill squad doesn't go this way, you might need a wizard here, especially because there's this elixir collector here. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3, you know, 4. If you're, you know, so it's going to be a stretch, but like, you know, you save your wizards to the end for the last minute or so. Okay. So basically, you know, just to recap, okay, you've got a balloon on this cannon, you've got a balloon on this archer tower, boom, okay, they're gone. You know, deploy them as close to those structures as possible, okay? Then right next to this cannon, there's a spawn site. You're going to put one barbarian down. It's going to trigger a bunch of, you know, it's going to trigger a giant bomb in there probably. You're going to put a giant in there. It's going to go to the cannon, but it's going to die. Just let it die out. It's going to pull the clan castle troops out. It's not going to pull all of them out. You're going to drop another giant in there. It's going to keep pulling troops out. You need to see three wizards come out, okay? You're going to then lure over to this laboratory with an archer. And between this elixir storage and this laboratory, you're going to alternate placing down archers. You're only taking four, so, you know, you don't even have that many. You need to get them, like, you know, tightly bunched, okay? And then you're going to deploy your clan castle kill squad and your barbarian king, okay? Actually, you know, and actually just hold off on your archer queen because you really need to path her correctly. So just deploy your barbarian king and your kill squad. That should be more than enough. Then you're going to drop, you know, you're going to drop a golem here. To take out this giant bomb, you're going to drop a golem over here in order to take out that small bomb. As soon as the small bomb goes off, you're going to deploy both of your wall breakers, you know, right here, okay? So they path in and they break that. They have to break this wall. That's, like, the most important, okay?
once they break that wall, you know, just go at, you know, your golems are going to go in, your kill squad's going to go in, and then you can deploy your archer queen. Once your barbarian king starts, you know, going in that way, deploy your archer queen really close to that site, right behind him, so the barbarian king and the golems tank for her, and she'll like help take out stuff and just monitor. Ignore that line, that was my mistake. And just monitor their health to see like when you need to press their ability buttons. Okay, and then what you're gonna do is, you know, one barbarian here to take out a likely giant bomb, and then hog attack, okay? And you're going to take either four heals or three heals and a jump. It's up to you. If you use the jump, you got to make sure that it's in here. And it doesn't overlap into this compartment, okay? And then, you know, your hogs are going to work. You're putting heal spells down, blah, blah, blah. After most of the defenses go down, then you can start putting your wizards down. You know, you're going to put one here, and you're going to put one here. And they're going to start cleaning up. You got to make sure that all these defenses have already gone down so they can clean up all these buildings. You might need one here, and then you might need one here, okay? And, or you can just save you can save one of the wizards to, like, the last, you know, minute or so. So,
that's it. That's the best I can do. All right, let me know if you have any questions in clan chat.